Now, in our previous lecture, we have solved numerical based on LMTD method for the shell and tube heat exchanger, or we can say that the cross flow heat exchanger. Now let's solve some more numericals. A finned tube single pass cross flow heat exchanger with both fluids unmixed as shown in figure is used to heat air with hot water. So hot water is our hot fluid, air is our cold fluid. The overall heat transfer rate is 200 kilowatts. So this is the value of Q. The water enters the tube at 85 degrees Celsius and leaves at 40 degrees Celsius. So this is our TH1 and this is our TH2. While the air enters the finned side at 15 degrees Celsius and leaves at 50 degrees Celsius. So this is our TC1 and this is our TC2. The overall heat transfer coefficient is 75 watt per meter square Kelvin. So this is the value of U. Calculate the surface area required. In this numerical, we have to find out the surface area. So we know we have one equation, Q is equal to UA delta T into F. By using that equation, we can easily calculate the required area capital A. But for that, we need value of Q, which is already given in question, value of U, which is also given in question. So we have to find out value of F and delta T. So to find out value of F and delta T, we required all the values of four temperature, TH1, TH2, TC1 and TC2, which is available in question. So from this equation, we can get value of A. Now, to find out value of P, F, we have to calculate first P and R. For P and R, we need this value of temperature. So putting the value of this, we can get the value of P as 0.5. Value of R is 1. Now by using graph, we can easily calculate the value of correction factor F. As you can see, P is 0.5. So 0.5 is this. Okay. R is 1. So this is the line of R is equal to 1. So this R is equal to 1 and 0.5 is going to intersect between, yes, this is 0.5. This is line of 1. So it is going to intersect something between here. So it gives value of F as nearly 0.7. Or we can say that it is going to be 0.5 and 1. So it is going to intersect at this point. So it should be not 0.7, it should be 0.89 or 0.9 something. Okay. So now let's put whatever value, 0.7, it's not going to affect the answer much. Now delta T, we know all the four temperature values, so we can easily calculate delta T by putting values in this equation, delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by ln delta T1 by delta T2. So delta T1 is TH1 minus TC2 and delta T2 is TH2 minus TC1. So putting the value, we will get logarithmic mean temperature difference is 29.7 degrees Celsius. So putting the values, all the values, Q is already 200 kilowatt, U is 75 watt per meter square Kelvin, F is 0.9, but suppose if we put 0.7 and delta T is 29.7, so we will get the answer 128.3 meter square. Let's solve one more numerical. Air is flowing at the rate of 5 kg per second. So this is the flow rate, is to be heated. So this is our cold fluid. So this is the value of M of C, is going to be heated in shell and tube heat exchanger from 20 to 50. So this is our TC1 and TC2 with hot water entering at 90 and exit at 60. So this is our TH1 and this is our TH2. So we know all the values of the four temperature. The overall heat transfer coefficient is 400 watt per meter square Kelvin. So this is value of capital U. The length of the heat exchanger is 2 meter. So this is the length which is given. Determine the surface area of the heat exchanger and the number of tubes which is required. Okay. So for this numerical is going to be solved for the two different configuration. First one is for the 1 and 2 shell and tube type of heat exchanger. The second is for the 4 shell and tube type of heat exchanger. Here the tubes are scheduled 43x4 nominal diameter. Okay. So here, as you know, we know the value of TC1, TC2, we know the mass flow rate of the cold fluid. So by using this equation, we can easily calculate value of Q. This is the energy balance by using energy balance equation. We can also find out the unknown mass flow rate of the hot fluid, but it is not required right now. So this is the value of Q. Now, we solve this numerical for the first case for 1 to 2 shell and tube heat exchanger. So, to find out the required surface area capital A, again we need to find out the correction factor F. For find out correction factor F, we need to find out value of T and R. So, as we all know the temperature, values of all the 4 temperature, we can easily calculate P and R by putting values in this equation. So, P is 0.43 and R is 1. So again, by using graph for this 1 to 2 shell and tube type of heat exchanger, we can easily calculate value of F, which is going to be nearly 0.9. Now, here you can see this is a special case where logarithmic mean temperature difference is going to be delta T1 or delta T2. Why? So, because here you can see this is our TC1 and this is TC2. 20 and 50. This is TH1 and this is TH2 90, 60. So delta T1, so if you calculate delta T1, which is going to be, delta T1 is TH1 minus TC2. So TH1 is 90 and TC2 is 20 to 50. Okay. TC2 is 50. So 90 minus 50, it is going to be 40. So delta T1 is 40. Also, this is our TH2 minus TC1, it is going to be 60 minus 20, so it is also 40 degrees. So we know the case, if delta T1 and delta T2 is going to be same for counter flow heat exchanger, so LMTD, logarithmic mean temperature difference for that is going to be either delta T1 or delta T2, which is 40 degrees Celsius. So we know the value of delta T, we know the value of correction factor F, we have already find out value of Q, and the value of U is already given in equation, so by using equation, we can find out value of area. So here our area is going to be 10.47 meter square. So this is our area. So now we are going to calculate the heat transfer surface area for the one tube. So for one tube, we can easily find out by using pi dl. The diameter is already given in the question, which is 0.02667. The length is given in the question, which is 2 meter. So this is our length. So this is the area. Now area of one tube, the total surface area required for the required heat transfer rate is 10.47. So number of tubes can be easily calculated by dividing the value 10.47 divided by 0.16. This is the area which is going to be provided by one tube. So 63 tubes are required for the 10.47 meter square of area. So this is answer for the first case. Now we are going to calculate same procedure for the second case, which is 2 to 4 shell and tube heat exchanger. So for 2 to 4 shell and tube heat exchanger, the value of Q will remain same, the value of P and R going to be same, but this graph is going to be changed. So according to value of P and R, we will get value of F, which is nearly equal to 0.97. So for value of F 0.97, if we calculate the number of tubes required with the same equation, we will get nearly 58 tubes is going to be required. Okay, so these are the both. So these are the both cases for the calculation of the tubes required. Now we are going to discuss NTU method for the heat exchanger. At this point, we have discussed LMTD method for the heat exchanger. Now we are going to discuss NTU method for the heat exchanger, number of transfer unit method. In our previous semester in heat transfer subject, we have already derived equation for the NTU, or we can say that the effectiveness for the parallel flow heat exchanger as well as counter flow heat exchanger. We have used dimensionless parameters or dimensionless terms like heat capacity ratio, capital R, or we can denote by capital C. C mean by C maximum, where C is heat capacity of hot fluid or cold fluid, which is mass flow rate into specific heat. So now let's revise that NTU method. why there is a requirement of NTU method, because as you can see, by using LMTD method, we can calculate the required area of the heat exchanger. But if when we know the inlet and outlet temperatures values, if we do not know the outlet temperature value, then we have to apply the trial and error method so many times to get a required desired output. So to avoid the trial and error procedure, the method of number of transfer unit based on the concept of heat exchanger effectiveness is used. There are some terms which is going to be used in NTU method. First one is capacity ratio, heat capacity ratio, which is C mean by C max. So what is C mean and C max? C is a heat capacity, so that mass flow rate into specific heat. So in heat exchanger we have two fluids, hot fluids and cold fluid. So we can calculate heat capacity for both hot fluid and cold fluid. Whichever value is lesser than the other one is going to be C mean, and the maximum value is going to be C max. And the ratio of this C mean and C max is known as the heat capacity ratio, which is denoted by C star. Second one is a heat exchanger effectiveness. We have already defined heat exchanger effectiveness in our previous semester, that it is the ratio of actual heat transfer for any heat exchanger divided by maximum possible heat transfer rate for heat exchanger. We know that we can easily find out the actual heat transfer rate by using this energy balance equation, that rate of heat loosened by the hot fluid, which can be easily calculated by mCp Th1 minus Th2, or rate of heat gain by the cold fluid, which is mCp Tc2 minus Tc1. So this is the, by using this equation, we can get the value of actual Q. And for Q max, we know that the fluid with maximum temperature difference and minimum heat capacity is going to be have maximum heat transfer rate. So for Q max, either we have mCp, this is Th1 minus Tc1, because Th1 minus Tc1 is the highest temperature difference in a heat exchanger. So the fluid with the highest temperature difference, which is Th1 minus Tc1, with minimum heat capacity, because the fluid which have minimum heat capacity is going to produce more temperature difference. So if Cc is less than Ch, so that if heat capacity of cold fluid is lesser than the heat capacity of hot fluid, then cold fluid is going to have maximum heat transfer rate, which is mCpC, because this is the lowest value, and maximum temperature with maximum temperature difference, which is Th1 minus Tc1. If Ch is less than Cc, so that the heat capacity of hot fluid is less than heat capacity of cold fluid, then the maximum heat transfer is going to be achieved by the hot fluid, which is mCp Th1 minus Tc1. So it depends on the values of the numerical, whether Cc is less than Ch or whether Ch is less than Cc, so that we can find out Q maximum accordingly. So our effectiveness is going to be either Ch Th1 minus Th2 divided by C mean Th1 minus Tc1, or Cc Tc2 minus Tc1 divided by C mean Th1 minus Tc1. So number of transfer unit, which is denoted by NTU, the equation is AU divided by C mean. Now we have already derived equation for the effectiveness or NTU for counter flow heat exchanger and parallel flow heat exchanger in our previous semester in our heat transfer subject. So for counter flow heat exchanger, we know the equation is 1 minus exponential of minus NTU, 1 minus C mean by C max. We have denote this C mean by C max by capital R, or we can denote it by capital C also, and this is going to be 1 minus R exponential of minus NTU 1 minus R. And in case of parallel flow, it was 1 minus exponential of minus NTU 1 plus R upon 1 plus R. Okay, so these are the equations which we have already derived. You can refer previous semesters subjects links. Now there are some special case in this equation. There are two limiting cases. First one is when C mean by C max equal to 1. So we know that this is the equation for the counter flow heat exchanger. So here you can see that if in a counter flow heat exchanger C mean by C maximum, if it becomes 1, then this is 1 minus 1, it is going to be 0. So e raised to 0, it is going to be 1. So that 1 minus 1 is going to be 0. So here also, if we put 1 instead of C mean by C max, it is going to be e raised to 0, so that d1. Again, this is C mean by C max, so that 1, so 1 minus 1, 0. So it is 0 by 0, which is indeterminate. So we have to apply L-Hospital rule. So if we apply L-Hospital rule, denote this C mean by C max by R, and if we put limit R tends to 1 and differentiate this equation, then we will get effectiveness is equal to NTU divided by 1 plus NTU. Okay. So for the case when C mean by C max is equal to 1, then effectiveness for the counterfeit exchanger is going to be NTU divided by 1 plus NTU. Now, if C mean by C max is going to equal to 1 for the parallel fluid exchanger, so you can see for parallel 1 plus 1, which is going to be 2. Here also 1 plus 1, which is going to be 2. So it is going to be 1 by 2 in bracket 1 minus exponential e raised to minus 2 NTU. Okay. Now, second limiting case, which is going to be C, if C mean by C max equal to 0. So when C mean by C max is equal to 0, so for this equation, for counterflow heat exchanger, if we put 0 instead of this, then, or for the parallel flow heat exchanger, if we put 0 instead of C mean by C max, in both cases, we will get effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus NT. So these are the two limiting cases for the parallel flow heat exchanger and counter flow heat exchanger for NTU methods. Here we can see that effectiveness is a function of NTU as well as flow arrangement as well as heat capacity ratio. Now, in previous semester we have derived equation for the NTU for counter flow configuration as well as for the parallel flow configuration. But it is very complex to derive particular equation for the effectiveness for a cross flow heat exchanger or mixed flow Shannon tube type heat exchanger. Still, there are some research paper which derive some equations for the cross flow and Shannon tube heat exchanger. So these are the equations for the effectiveness for different configuration. This is for counter flow heat exchanger. This is for parallel flow heat exchanger. This is for cross flow mixed C minimum mixed and C maximum unmixed. This is again cross flow C maximum mixed and C minimum unmixed. This is for shell and tube heat exchanger. So these are the equations which we are going to use in our numerical.